Hi, I'm Dhristi, and I'm a history student. So, like, I understand the importance of people when they want to sketch their names in history books and have someone to talk about it. My poem is based on my experience with history. It's titled The Script. Let's start. I began by counting the packets of medicine she had at her counter. The script written by the man in a white coat was handed over me to translate, to tell how many tablets she had to take. 2 churns in honey and warm milk, 5 tablets on empty stomach, 3 of fusty gels on her broken joints, and the list went on. The only thing that I felt concerned was about her becoming Meera and feeling her sense of self-love. The script didn't talk nothing about losing her son to Shivaji, who administered her son intoxicants to celebrate his life. These juices of grapes, packed steel glasses, broken glasses, piercing skins, needed a short script requiring betadine and band-aid, but those broken glasses didn't take her skin apart. It took her home in Mathura, where she had plans to live with cows and lights and Radha and her Krishna. Her soul aches to go back to eat pedas with her Krishna, but there are no medicines prescribed for it. Script written talk nothing about losing her Krishna to Yamuna, who administered him to find his son in her waters. Cold waters covered in silt took him away to Yamuna, but they left her alone under the Chandrama. If you ever go underneath water, the water in your lungs must be pumped out, but what about the water inside your body, creating turbulent waves to reach her crush, to reach her Krishna and their son? The skipped heartbeats when she heard about her Krishna dissolving in Yamuna were different from when she was 12 in a red veil under the starry sky when she met her Krishna's eyes. The script didn't prescribe depressor, but told her to get paracetamol. As if the man writing the script couldn't feel her skipped heartbeats and heart waves that roll to find them back. I pushed my eyes over the script that I paraphrased to her. Her eyes had darkness, darker than the night she had been through. Her body barely had the pain for the dupatta she captured in a movie-like snapshot. But the dilemma was identifying the cunts, the villain. Was he the person sitting above the skies playing her fate? Or the grey matter inside her head reminded her about them in spite of the drugs failing her brain. The script I read was scripted by a man who spent years in books to win his doctorate. The script I heard didn't have a script. It was a tragedy written by the waves that Sita made when she jumped into the pyre. The protagonist of the unwritten script, who will be forgotten from history, unawarely looks over me and asks, how many tablets more to eat? And I remember I'm just a translator translating the script from English to Hindi that she cannot read. I translate her the script and it is 3:14 p.m. Time for her to take Sita Palavi Churan while I sit in your attendance to tell her life script to you. You might not remember when you sleep tonight, but she still chants to Sita and Rama and Krishna and Yamuna and Meera, wishing to dissolve in Mathura. It is February 11th today. The protagonist of our story now lies in the soil. No, dancing with her Krishna and Mathura with her bhajans and creating her Rasleela. She's falling in love again. And I won't be able to script and tell her in poetry to you because she is Meera who found her Krishna. She's writing her scripts in the stars. Thank you.